Hi, I'm Stuart Nivison. I head HSBC's Trade Operation for Europe. HSBC is particularly proud to sponsor this award, and never more so than this year. It's a particularly difficult year for businesses in the UK and for banks. And right throughout the country, there are companies who are finding that domestic demand for their goods has fallen. They're also finding at the same time that sterling has weakened, so their goods are cheaper overseas. And many of these companies are having to revisit who they sell to, which markets they go to, reinvent their product or reposition their product so they can sell overseas. And the companies that have won this award have excelled at that. They've proven themselves able to do that in a world environment. They've succeeded, and they've been put up on a pedestal effectively as an example for others to follow. And I think we'll be using this along with others to show what can be done in the UK.
I'm particularly pleased to be here today for a few reasons, but to be honest, not least because I was a bit worried security wouldn't let any bankers into the building. Thankfully, they did. But primarily because this is it's an all too rare chance for us to get together business, to get journalists together, to get banks together, and to get the government here as well. And for all of us not to be fighting with each other and blaming each other for things that go wrong, but to focus on something positive, and in particular, innovation and trade. And if you look back through history, whether it's wars or whether it's the Asian financial crisis, the meltdown we had in South America, the problems in Russia before, it's innovation and trade that has led countries out of problems in the past. And if you look across the UK today, we've got companies all through the country who are sitting finding that the domestic demand for their product has fallen. They're also finding that sterling's weakened, so the goods are cheaper overseas. And some of those will just scale back and they'll do less and they'll shrink or maybe they'll fail. But some of them will change what they do and how they do it. They'll look overseas, they'll go on the trade missions, they'll look for new markets and new buyers, and they'll change what they do. They'll change their model, and they'll be the winners of tomorrow. And the reason I'm excited about this award in particular is that everyone that we have here in some way fits that bill. And we can move away to some extent from the comments I hear all too often that Britain doesn't have any industry, it doesn't have any exports, it's all service-based. It's simply not true. I think we need to make a point ourselves of, as often as possible, making the good news stick so that people are aware of it and think about it.